relative and that there's no real moral order. And, you know, that alleviates you of responsibility. And that's why that's such an attractive message to people. But the problem is that it kills you. It kills your soul, so to speak, because, well, we need to talk about this technically. So, you know, there are systems, neurological systems, that underlie your experience of negative emotion, and there are neurological systems that underlie your experience of positive emotion, and they're separate systems. They obviously interact, but they're separate systems. So, but the positive emotion system, well, there's two of them, but one of them sort of kicks in when you get something that you want. So, you know, you're hungry and you eat, and that feels good. So that's kind of the simple one. But there's a more sophisticated one that I think is even more active in people. And it's the one that tells you that you're moving forward towards something worthwhile. And that's actually the one that gives people that sense of meaningful engagement in their life on a moment-to-moment basis. So, and it's also something that doesn't have to go away. Like, if you're hungry and you eat, well, that's good. But it's over, and then you're on to the next thing, right? It's not exactly sustaining, it's just necessary. That's called consummatory reward, by the way. This other reward system is called incentive reward. The incentive reward system works on dopamine, this neurochemical dopamine, which is also the neurochemical tracts that opiates and cocaine and amphetamines, the drugs that people really like to use, alcohol often for some people, activate. And so you might say, if you don't have enough meaning in your life, then you're more prone to addiction. And that's definitely the case even with the rats. When you take a rat and put him in a cage by himself, he has nothing to do. And then you give him access to cocaine, he'll get addicted to the point where he won't do anything but take cocaine. But if you throw the rat back in with a bunch of other rats and he gets to do bad things, then it's very hard to get him addicted to cocaine. And so the purposeless rat is prone to addiction. Well, it's the same with human beings. Now, here's a corollary to that, which is pretty cool. So the magnitude of the reward you experience as you're moving towards a goal is proportionate to the importance of the goal. So that means the more important the goal you pick, the more possibility there is for the kind of reward, let's say, it's really a state of being, that is life-affirming. And it is directly life-affirming in that, you know, if you're in a football game and it's an important football game, maybe you break a finger. And, you know, normally that's a problem. It hurts. And you're going to stop doing whatever you're doing. But if you're right in the middle of the game, then you'll be so amped up on this reward system that it's analgesic. It stops the pain. It also suppresses anxiety. So if you have a purpose, then it's analgesic. It takes some of the pain out of life. It's very positive in that it motivates and energizes you and focuses you and makes you able to remember and pay attention. And it quells fear.
Discipline starts with waking up early. It really does. You absolutely have to apply it to things beyond waking up early. It is working out every day, making yourself stronger and faster.
fortunate enough to live in relatively peaceful times, at least the vast majority of us,